about our pilot project just outside of one of our business units, Ready Mix West Indies, where we'll be launching in Trinidad the short slab methodology into concrete roads. If you look in the background, you would see that there are different stabilization processes that is being used for the base. But what I really want to describe in this pilot project, the key component is that in the concrete surface, we do not use any steel at all. So basically, there's major cost savings with respect to that, one, and to ease of construction. And literally, this project is just a two-day project with respect to the concrete paving aspect.
Ready Mix has designed this according to specifications, and it's really good to see that as the TCL group, we are marketing this concrete roads for the country and the region as a whole.
My name is Celine Bridgedal. I'm attached to the Ministry of Works Pure Unit, and I'm here tonight to witness the construction of concrete pavement using short slab methods. I can see this technology being useful within the ministry as an alternative to asphalt roads in areas with poor soil conditions, heavy traffic, and also for maintenance. Right now, we are in discussions with TCL to partner with them on a pilot project to see the benefits, the financial and the engineering benefits of this methodology.
What you see behind me is an active construction site where we are doing our pilot project with the short slab methodology. You would see there are various stages from the inception of where the trucks come in, bringing the concrete, to where the guys are vibrating it. There's also the vibratory screed, which moves the concrete as well as gives it the first leveling process. Then the guys behind, they are doing the secondary stage of bump cutting and floating. We use two floating processes. The first using the channel float, the second with a magnesium float. Why a magnesium float? What the magnesium float does is that it draws the cement paste to the surface, thickening and densifying the cement paste to the top of the concrete road, making it a little bit more rigid as well as giving longevity to the surface to prevent some of the surface defects commonly associated with conventional concrete roads.
He's actually doing what they call, he's pokering the concrete. That process is take off the extra air pockets from the concrete. So what you call when you break your boxing, when you remove your boxing, we have no something like we call honeycomb, where you would see the stone actually not joining onto one another.